As the song goes, it's the most wonderful time of the year, a time when giving becomes the priority and hearts turn toward the needy. But in Fort Lauderdale,
selling food is a right.
A scrooge of a law has led to protest and national attention. And the man in the middle, 90-year-old Arnold Abbott, lovingly referred to as Santa Claus.
I love you, brother. Shalom.
The World War II veteran made headlines when police ticketed him not once, not twice, but four times for violating the city's public feeding ordinance.
I felt something on my arm. It was a hand, and the officer said, drop that plate right now. So I had a weapon in my hand. That was kind of funny.
Video of Abbott defying the new law went viral. When we caught up with Abbott, he was preparing to hit the streets again with a fresh batch of meals.
We don't serve the same food day after day. We serve different food. And we want to make sure the food is nutritious and delicious and pretty.
Abbott has spent the last 23 years feeding and educating the city's homeless.
It's a mission of love. Love is in our name. Love is what we do.
Through a nonprofit called Love Thy Neighbor, he trains the homeless for jobs in the food business. For Abbott, it's not only a heart of compassion that motivates him, it's honoring the legacy of his late wife, who also dedicated her life to the poor. Each week, he heads to the beach to feed hundreds, but some say that public location has become a problem.
And so it's really set up to address an issue where we have some downtown parks that were being completely overwhelmed by these feedings.
Fort Lauderdale Mayor Jack Seiler landed in hot water over the law, but says he's not the bad guy.
The park almost became off limits to others in the community on days those feedings were taking place. Families were complaining to us, children were complaining to us, people that wanted to visit the library were complaining to us.
Seiler says groups are welcome to feed the homeless as long as they follow a few guidelines.
Nobody passed any ordinance that restricted the homeless access anywhere in downtown. All we said, all right, in terms of feedings going forward, there are going to be, ideally we'd like them indoors. Ideally, we'd like them to have restrooms. We'd like them to have a, kitchen or something. Bathrooms available. Clean water available. That would be the ideal situation to host these feedings.
Abbott and his supporters say those guidelines make it difficult for smaller charities. He also believes public places should be open to everyone, including homeless men, women, and children.
The beach has always been outdoors, so everybody can enjoy the beauty of it. The only people excluded are the homeless.
Florida isn't the only state to have these, quote, anti-homeless laws. These laws are actually popping up in many states across the country.
According to a report from the National Law Center on Homelessness and Poverty, anti-homeless laws have passed in more than 180 cities across the United States since 2009. Just a few hours north, Orlando restricts begging. In California, Santa Cruz bans sitting or lying down on public sidewalks. Overseas, cities have installed these anti-homeless benches to cut down on loitering and sleeping in public places. As homeless populations grow, city leaders often find themselves torn between compassion and maintaining space for the general public. To Abbott, laws like the one in Fort Lauderdale are un-American.
I fought so many years for civil rights that I'm not going to let this one go by.
He says he stared down the KKK and will take on the city and anyone else who comes between him and his religious duty.
My right to feed my brother, to make sure that the hungry get fed.
A fight he says he will continue until there is no longer breath in his body. David Brody, CBN News, in Fort Lauderdale, Florida.